Yes, we received the sad news last night of a fire incident involving the container housing the smart card readers for the Ondo election. And let me give you a little bit of statistics. We require 4,100 smart card readers for the Edo election, including spare smart card readers in case of malfunction on election day. We have those numbers in Edo, in Ondo. However, we also required 1,000 smart card readers for training so that the ADOC staff are properly trained using the smart card readers. So we got additional 1,000 smart card readers from our office in Oshun State. So we had 5,100 smart card readers good to go for Ondo. But unfortunately, from the reports I'm getting, we have lost all 5,100 smart card readers in that container in Ondo. Will that affect the elections? I'm glad to say that we have recovered from that. The election in Ondo is going to go ahead. We have huge capacity in the neighboring states to get additional smart card readers. And I had a discussion with the REC in Oyo. In Oyo, we have almost 7,000 smart card readers. So getting 5,000 to support Ondo is not an issue at all. This is not a general election, which is holding nationwide. It's an off-season election. So we have recovered in Ondo while investigation continues on the cause of fire in our office in Ondo. The Ondo election will not be affected by what happened yesterday to our smart card readers. The fire incident only affected the container housing the card readers. And it's the same container that has housed the card readers since 2015. It was used in 2015, used in 2016 for the governorship elections, used in 2019. So it's not that we have moved the card readers to an unsafe place. But learning from the experience of what happened in Ondo, we have also taken measures to ensure that there is no a repeat occurrence of this kind of incidents in Edo, Edo State. So Ondo election will go ahead. Thank you very much.